Welcome back for some more Outer Worlds. Constable just visited her. Got some bounties to take care of now. Esther, hello.
Somebody's been running around town raving about a colony ship. Plague must have gone into their brain matter.
Well, yeah. What do you do here?
Oh, I'm an actuary. That means I keep tabs on a worker's living expenses. How much it costs to feed, clothe, shelter, bury, and replace your average human worker. Technically, I'm employed by the Spacer's Choice Department of Human Resources.
Okay. I'll leave you be.
You're some sort of freelancer?
I'm a freelancer. I lance for free. It's hard to tell what buildings you can go into and what you can't. We're headed for the cannery. Definitely. Just want to see anything else first. It's a cannery worker. Cannery workers. So what is this thing? Wanted. Oh, these are the people that are wanted. Gulam Antrim? Wanted for destruction of company property, murder of company workers in good standing, theft, and unauthorized use of medical supplies. Bertie Cotton. Sedition. They all have generous bounties. Vandalism and unlicensed practice of medicine on seditious criminals. Well, we got slots for more posters. I noticed that.
Wish we had some better rations.
At least you got your health.
There's always that. Well, until there isn't. That must be the mechanic shop. Interesting, not everything is lit up. Like, we got the general store and the cantina, that's about it. Doesn't highlight the dentist or anything like that. Like, here's a dentist. But unless I'm missing something, which is possible.
Wish we had some better rations.
Not like outside the city where we can go into so many of them. And those buildings, it was clear which ones you couldn't go into because it said evicted on them. On the ones you couldn't get into.
I don't have time for this.
What do you have time for? I guess I'm going in the cannery. Is this the cannery? Oh no, this is off from the... That's the maintenance division. Here we go. I thought the lights meant that you could go in there. Alright, yeah. I think just the cannery is left. When you life gives you lemons, consider it a free trial from our friends at Spacer's Choice. Alright, logs. The Edgewater Salt Tuna Canning Facility strictly adheres to Spacer's Choice standards of health and safety. Notice, schedule your sick leave with the Spacer's Choice foreman and or supervisor. Be considerate toward other members of the Spacer's Choice family. Allow 2 to 4 weeks to process and approve your scheduled sick leave. God. Lost hours must be compensated to the company. See Reed if you're having trouble paying for your sick leave. We'll try to arrange wage deductions instead. Oh God. Remember, work invigorates the spirit. Sickness in the body reflects sickness in the mind and sickness in the character. If you find yourself falling ill, it may be time to schedule a meeting with our local vicar. Wow. These people are horrible. Alright, that goes up to the tower. We can talk to Reed. Let's look around this area first. I guess we're after hours. Hi.
Sorry, I've got a lot to do.
It's a take. Sprats. Dead sprats. Oh, we go down. Loose lips, pink slips. Barred. Barred from entry. Notifications lost and found. Found one left hand. Severed at the wrist, some bone damage. People, this is our second unscheduled amputation in as many months. Please exercise caution and safety around machinery. Maintenance fees will be deducted from your pay. So you can schedule amputations? Only you can protect fourth quarter profits. Vending machine.
Hey.
Hey, hey. Well, if he wasn't sitting in here, we could have at this stuff. Oh, I don't want to buy. I want to sell. Light assault rifle, light pistol. Stun baton. Grenade launcher, yes. So I got two. Oh, one's a light assault rifle and one's a light pistol. I like that sound. Makeshift low pressure. Well, it gives you a bonus for tech skills. Lockpick plus 5 for that one. Yeah, it is. That's my chips or whatever. Wanted Doc Maybell. That's interesting. It puts it into, oh, logs. Okay. Shower facility. I say I love the theme with the guitar. Classic. Instant classic. Gyro sight. So yeah, try to finish exploring all this stuff. I'll be going up the tower to finally talk to Tobson. Running self-examination. Help yourself to a refreshing tin of Spacer's Straw while you wait. Power source, Spacer's Choice, Electrical Transformer. Transformer status and power regulator responsive. Query. Geothermal facility. The Emeraldvale region is powered by the Spacer's Choice geothermal facility. Spacer's Choice is proud to bring the colonists of Halcyon moderately innovative technology at a reasonable price. Spacer's Choice, the best you can afford. They're like, I don't know. Somehow they're, I don't know if they're refreshingly honest or too stupid to lie. Return to route and disengage. Really? Okay, that could get me in trouble. Let's talk to Tobson first. I mean, they'll certainly know that I've done that. And I'll probably have lots of people after me. It's very tempting, though, just to see what would happen. Yeah, let's go up top. It wasn't that. Where was it again? Oh, out here. Bones and gears don't mix. Worker injuries affect our bottom line. Use caution when operating heavy machinery. Asterisk. Oh, this is back out here. Oh, this is the, yeah. Let me just make sure I didn't miss anything in here. Any door. Well, I can. Oh. Vending machine, okay, good. Let's back out there.
It's all right.
I
got a lot to do.
I'm sure you do. Alright, let's go up.
The grease monkey, Argo.
I'm sorry, Mr. Tobson, sir. You asked why it's taking so long to fix. The answer's technical.
Oh.
Don't apologize.
Parvati grew up.
Try using small words for me.
Oh, the pans bust open in the oven because she's set to cook saltuna, which isn't what we've got. Mr. Tobson, I think there's someone here to see you.
Focus, Miss Holcomb. You and I are still talking. Let's start over. Walk me through the process. Show me where it's going awry.
Well, sure. It's mostly on account of what we're feeding into.
Seems we've got a guest.
I pushed
Sorry
forward.
Now, Parvati, I do wish you'd spoken up. I do apologize. I was given no forewarning of your arrival, or I might have welcomed you at the gates myself.
I got too close. I'll wait until you're finished.
You were saying, Miss Holcomb.
It's just what Bess needs is a proper refurbish. I can bandage her up and what all, but she's just old. Sorry, I'm sorry. I'll do better.
And I do wish you'd stop referring to our cannery as Bess. Personification of company property is strictly contrary to the Spacer's Choice Code of Conduct. My apologies. I am not in the habit of allowing my guests to witness such a row. Now, what can I do for you?
Are you Reed? I was told I should talk to you.
I'm Reed Tobson, Outpost Administrator. I cannot help but notice you are not in uniform.
I don't work for Spacer's Choice.
Of course not. I don't have that kind of luck. Seems I allowed my excitement to run away with my wits. Been a few seasons since we've had a visitor pass through.
My ship needs repairs. I'm looking for a power regulator.
Only regulator we got is hooked up to the town transformer. Mr. Tobson ain't liable to be keen on dismantling it.
I beg your pardon. I am most emphatically not keen on any such thing. I can't let you have our power regulator. But I happen to know of another one. And I happen to know exactly how you may retrieve it without frying yourself in the process.
Frying myself?
Oh, yes. Saw someone put his hands on a regulator while the power was running. His legs were still twitching when we buried him. There's a power regulator in the old botanical lab. It's mostly abandoned, so all that power is being squandered.
Well, they need
Go
that.
Go down to the geothermal plant. Reroute power from the botanical district over to us. Once their power shut down, you can have their regulator and be along on your way.
I know the place. With the greenhouse, right?
That's right. You've been there. Good. That gives me hope. I have nothing against Adelaide and her followers, you see. The people living in the botanical labs. They're deserters, former workers. I need them back at their posts. I need them to come home.
Why?
Edgewater is struggling. We haven't hit our production quota in years. If we don't meet our quotas this year, the company might shut us down for good. I need those workers back at their stations.
Well, I've seen Edgewater. I don't blame those workers for walking out. Maybe if you treated them better.
Neither do I. The fault was entirely mine. I pushed them too hard. My hope is that by cutting off their power, you will convince those deserters to come back to town. Before you go to the plant, I want you to stop by the botanical lab. Speak to their leader, Adelaide. Tell her the power's about to go, and that it's time her band of deserters came back to town.
I've seen these deserters.
You spoke with them? Are they keeping well?
You should go see for yourself.
Believe me, I have tried. Law knows I have tried, but they will not have audience with me.
Law knows?
Nonetheless, they did speak to you, or at the very least, refrained from opening fire on you. That is reason enough for hope.
Can't make any promises.
Of course, I understand completely. Here, let me give you the passcode to the geothermal plant. A sign of good faith, for so politely listening to me as I ramble on.
Are you setting off for the Vale? Because I know my way around. I mean, in case you want a guide.
Follower.
I mean, if that's all right with you, Mr. Tobson. Sir.
I hesitate to part ways with Miss Holcomb, but I cannot deny that she is talented and may prove useful to you.
She'd be a good mechanic, some of the mechanic skills. As well as hopefully she's got some skills with using weapons as well. But yeah, we read about her in the logs, in the mechanical, like the house attached to the mechanics bay or whatever you'd call it. Mechanics shop. As I recall, well, it wasn't that long ago. There was a man and woman. I don't know if they were even married. I'm thinking not, because they separated them. The female ended up going off to another planet. She went to, a whole other planet. I think Terra 1 or Terra 3? I'm not sure. But, and the father, the guy, stayed here. And she sent him, she wasn't allowed to bring her daughter with her for whatever reason. So he raised her, and she told him, she doesn't have a name until you tell the corporation or whatever, what her name is, and her name is Parvati, so there you go. And now he is the daughter all grown up. But yeah, sure, I could use the company.
Great! I got my wrenches and diagnosticators and hairpins and engine tape, so...
Hairpins.
I'm all set!
Well, I am glad to hear that. Best of luck to you, and thank you again for your help. It is a lot to ask of a stranger, I know.
Well, she was fixing something. He doesn't care about that anymore all of a sudden. Alright, let's get going. Companion! New manager seminar. They help in a variety of ways. Provide combat support. Their skills enhance your skills. Okay. So do I effectively have better mechanics? Because I have her along. They increase your carrying capacity. You can unlock special companion combat abilities with the inspiration skill. Learn more about your companions in the companion ledger. Boop. Some people may require completing another quest before they will assist you. You can check your quest log for dependencies. Which is that? What's missing? Companions. Yeah, it's just what we've seen already. So I don't think... we have any dependencies with her. Workers are abandoning the town of Edgewater. Reed Tobson, Edgewater's administrator, wants to force these deserters to return to town by shutting off their power. I'd rather find another way. Reed asks you to deliver a message to Adelaide and her deserters. Come back to town because he's cutting off their power. Adelaide and her people are camped out in the botanical lab north of Edgewater. Yeah, we can just fast travel there. I want to return to Ludwig first, though. I think we're largely done with exploring Edgewater. We need to find these guys. More volumes, alright. You found a mention of Parvati's father's old terminal that he took a volume of A Young Spacer's Guide to Mechanical Engineering into the cannery and left it in an unused office. So, somewhere where we are. Oh, Abernathy. I was going to talk to him. And I ended the episode and then just walked away.
We better clear out of Mr. Thompson's office before we talk.
Okay.
Don't make me report you to Mr. Thompson.
Oh yeah, he might not... You might have to step a little closer to report him. Or me, rather.
Some old heads running around town talking about lost colony ships.
I'm missing some dialogue here. Requires Reed's key to unlock. Reed's key. I wonder if the... is that for the elevator?
My offer remains standing, should you reconsider.
I wanted to talk to you about something.
Go ahead.
Have you taken a look around your town lately?
It is my job to keep two eyes on my town. I am the steward of this place, and this is my watch post.
How long have you worked here?
I'm trying to remember. 25 years? 26? When you get to my age, the years just rush by. You stop counting altogether.
You don't look that old.
I remember looking out this window and seeing the Vale spread out from horizon to horizon. We were a sprawling town. We were booming. Times change, people change, but the Vale will always be here. Spacer's choice will always be here. Our work won't ever end. I take comfort in that.
Your town is falling to pieces.
I wish you wouldn't say things like that.
You disagree?
Yes, as a matter of fact. When I stand at my window and look out over my town, here's what I see. I see decent, loyal, hard-working people. I see a family. We are all part of the Spacer's Choice family. We are all doing what we were brought into this world to do.
You're loyal to Spacer's Choice.
This is a Spacer's Choice town. We're all part of the Spacer's Choice family here. The company keeps us warm, keeps us fed, keeps us working. Loyalty's got nothing to do with it, friend. This is good old-fashioned gratitude.
I wish I could get rid of the word Edgewater here. Let me ask you something else.
Go ahead.
What makes you think I can convince these deserters to come back?
That you are not one of us may work to your advantage. Adelaide and her folk loathe the people of Edgewater, you see. I admit the fault was mine. I'm about as diplomatic as a bristling canid. I just hope Adelaide and her folk will see their way past my flaws and return to town.
Well, sometimes people move on. It's the way of things.
Scripture tells us we all have our purpose in the world. Our work shows us that purpose. We should not have to move on from it. Yes, we have lost good workers to desertion. We have lost even more to plague. But it is why we must square our shoulders and carry on.
Do you and Adelaide have a personal history?
Losing Adelaide was the hardest. She was our only flavor specialist. When she walked away, I knew we were in trouble.
Doesn't answer my question.
Spacer's Choice Saltuna is renowned across the system for its quality flavors and additives. We used to sell citrus-flavored Saltuna in our heyday. Ever since Adelaide left, we have been reduced to selling unflavored and spearmint. Go ahead.
You seem pretty fixed on bringing Adelaide back to town.
Adelaide was our only flavor specialist. We are a Saltuna canning institution. Saltuna without flavor is like a cysty pig without tumors, borderline inedible.
Don't you people eat anything other than Saltuna?
Word up to me, friend. I'd stack our larders with Saltuna galore. No other brand of Saltuna adds as much vim or vigor to the body's humors. But, and this is something we must keep between the two of us, Saltuna is hard to come by. what with being a species indigenous to the seas of another world.
What world is that?
You mean you don't know? Why, Monarch, of course. Spacer's Choice ran a mighty fishing enterprise on that world. As it so turns out, Saltuna do not take as readily to the waters of Terra 2. Scrawnier than their monarch cousins, forces us to pack our cans with additives, you see.
So what are you canning here exactly?
Oh, we've scavenged together some organic material from the surrounding environs. Mostly organic, mostly local mushrooms.
Mostly.
Some of which possess a texture akin to a well-boiled slab of Saltuna. The difference is all but impossible to detect to any but the prizziest of palate. Go ahead.
We need to have a word about this plague.
Can we not? Talking about unpleasant things always gets my bile up.
How long has this plague been happening?
That I cannot say. There was no moment when the plagues began. Disease always lurks on the fringes of society, waiting to infect the idle and the lethargic. But in the last 10 years, the plagues have become progressively worse and increasingly frequent.
Everyone gets sick. You don't have to be idle or lethargic or weak of spirit.
Modern science disagrees with you, friend. It is a well-documented fact that the wealthiest in society do not suffer from ailments of the constitution. I believe plague is a test. It is a test of our loyalty and our fortitude, and it is one we will see through to the end.
You withhold medicine from your own workers.
If I had enough medicine to treat everyone who fell sick, I would, but I don't. I can't save everyone. So I have to choose.
If he's telling the truth, well, what can he do? That can't be easy for you.
It is not easy for me. And the moment it becomes easy is the moment I am no longer fit to serve. Spacer's Choice is a family. And the survival of the family is more important than the survival of the individual.
Well, he seems overall a good person. Far from perfect, and well indoctrinated into this Spacer's Choice thing. I should go. Alright, so where is this office that would hold this... It wouldn't be here, off his own... Hi. Parvati.
Hey, ma'am. Can we talk? Sorry. Can we talk?
Absolutely. Try talking to them. We'll come out of the elevator.
Sorry. You just want to get out of here. And you likely don't want to tag along like me. It's just... Mr. Tobson has his own view on matters. On account of it's his job and what all, but... That's not the only side of the tale.